Okay, so I'm sorry for that earlier kasi I didn't notice my time mark. So as I was saying earlier, no? So the position of Black's knight on d3 prevents White from exchanging rooks on e8. White will never be able to defend both weak spots at the same time. So let's see how White tried to dislodge the knight on d3 by attacking the support. Okay, suggest it's a very useful strategy, no? Kapag may pyesa na pumasok sa base mo using outpost, kagaya nito sa d3, do not attack the knight. What you attack is the support of the knight, which is c4. That's what White did in the game. So he played b3. Notice that if this support goes down, the knight on d3 goes down as well. So kumbaga sa gaming, no, kung sino man sa inyo yung nagko-computer gaming, usually, 'di ba, sa isang team kapag bumagsak yung support, mas madali nang pabagsakin din yung ibang team members. So after rook d8, now Black or Antonio might be considering an exchange sacrifice of his rook on the knight on d4 plus the pawn on c3, if plus a passed pawn on the c file, pwede yon. So tingnan natin ang gagawin ng White. Or White may also choose to do it himself by playing rook takes knight, pawn takes rook, and queen takes pawn. But that won't do too much for him kasi na Black is already superior in position. So after takes, Black maintains the support on c4. White withdrew the knight on f3. And after Antonio takes advantage of occupying this very important diagonal, White tries to exchange knight. Okay? He was able to remove the very strong knight on d3, but in return, the weakness on the back rank tells on him, no? Masyadong weak yung rank niya sa likod. And notice or take note how the Grandmaster took advantage of that. Okay, so in this position, Antonio tried to switch the rook on b8, trying to take advantage of the weakness of the back rank, which is not so easily countered kasi itong battery ng White on the e file ay medyo baliktad. Dapat yung queen yung nasa harap in this particular position kasi hindi niya masasalag yung pagpasok ng rook sa back rank. Let's say for example, okay, so in this position, White tries to relieve the pressure by exchanging queen e4, and then syempre ayaw ni Antonio yung queen d7. So ang plano niya is to invade the back rank of White para ma-attacking yung king ng White, no? Now White, instead of putting his queen again on maybe on e1 to prevent the rook from entering the first rank, pero after rook b2, papasok pa rin yung rook ng Black, and still it's advantage for him. So White can really do little about this invasion sa kanyang weakness sa kanyang first and second rank. Okay? But it's better off than capturing the pawn on c4, which is like a nail on his coffin, no? Siya na rin ang tumapos sa sarili niya after capturing the pawn on c4. After rook check, king h2, and then queen d1, nakita na natin na decisive na yung entry ng combination ng rook and queen ng Black compared mo sa White. Even White will emulate that by playing rook e8 check and maybe queen takes f7. It's too late for him kasi may mate threat na sa h1. So after king h3, attempting to escape via g4 square kung chumek yung Black sa ilalim, Black played queen f3. So it's already a goner for him. Wala na siyang magagawa para mapigilan yung mate sa h1. So in this position, pwede na mag-resign yung puti kasi hindi niya na mapipigilan yung check ng rook sa h1. And White plays a couple of move. Nag-check muna siya. And after king h7, he throw in the towel and it's the end of a game. Let's proceed to another game. Okay, so let's look at another game. This time, the Filipino Grandmaster is handling the white pieces against the same player. So the opening was initially a Sicilian defense, and it transposes to a kind of French defense. Usually, this opening is a typical. The pawn structure of this opening is typical of French tarash opening. No, yung may isolated pawn yung black kapalit ng activity. So in this position, both players proceeded to what we call book moves. So I'll just play it out. After knight g4 and b4, this is the end of the book move, or at least for my knowledge. Okay, so in this position, white won a pawn at nagkaroon siya ng majority of pawns sa queen side. If he can survive blocks, onslaught, or pressure sa position niya, he can win the game, actually, no, sa end game. So let's see, this time the tables are turned. Ang umaatake naman is yung American master against our very own Filipino grandmaster. Let's look at the game. Knight takes bishop, pawn takes knight, and then putting pressure on the pawn chain, a5, and then after an eventual b6, here, instead of defending the c5 point, Antonio pushes his pawn on c6. He believes that he can maintain his pawn there without losing his pawn on c6 or establishing a protected passpawn. Let's see. So, establishing a protected passpawn. Okay. Ang pawn sa c6, this is a passpawn, right? Sa, when we say passpawn, ito yung pawn na wala ng katapat na pawn or dadaan ng pawn para makain siya. Thereby, it gives your opponent, it should have at least one piece guarding this pawn or prevent it from, at least block or prevent it from queening. But in this position, it's kung nag-iisa lang yan, madali lang yan, tututukan lang yan, tas kakainin. Pero in this position, it was protected by the pawn on b5. Remember, the term protected passpawn is hindi lang passpawn na may suporta, no? Kundi kailangan sinusuportahan siya ng kasama niyang pawn. So, let's say for example, wala yung pawn sa b5 at may suporta siya ng knight sa d4 at saka ng rook sa c1, it's still not called protected passpawn. It shall be called protected passpawn kung may suporta siya sa b5 square. So let's see. White played bishop c5. Black played bishop c5, queen d3, rook e8, pressuring the e3 pawn. The grandmaster blocked it by knight d4, knight g4. And here in this position, it's very critical, no? Kasi parang wala nang magagawa si Antonio o yung grandmaster na Pilipino para suportahan yung pawn sa e3. And black's attack seems to be breaking through. Black has a possibility of queen h4 attacking on the king side, and the position looks bright for him, no? Let's see from the perspective of H-man. Okay, or H-man. Okay? So nakikita natin lakas ng pressure ng bishop sa diagonal, no? Sa b6 diagonal, or yung bishop niya sa c5, malakas ng pressure na sa g1 diagonal. Okay? Everything looks bright for him. But Antonio, instead of defending his position, switches his gear to counter-attack. Antonio surprisingly played queen to f5. And I think this move confuses black and thereby losing his way, no? Kung papansin mo, if the knight captures, the knight on g4 is threatened by the queen, but there's a possibility of capturing on e3, forking both white's rook on f1 and queen on f5, and possibly white will lose the knight on d4. Pero hindi natakot dun si Antonio kasi mayroon rin siyang, he made a threat of his own by putting his queen on f5, nagkaroon ng battery sa f file, at he threatens to capture the pawn on f7, giving a check and a possible attack. So, tingnan natin ang nangyari sa laro. After knight takes e3, queen takes f7, king h8, knight to e6, no? Hindi na siya natakot sa discovery ng bishop sa diagonal na to. Kasi, after knight e6, cover niya rin naman yung bishop. Pwede niyang i-capture next book. But, let's say for example, black is aware of that and surrenders his rook on e8 for the knight on e6. Rook takes e6, queen takes e6. The knight can play knight c2 check, but after the move king h1, knight takes a1 for example, yung activity ng white pieces compensate for that. So let's see how Antonio drove home the point by playing knight takes c5, knight d2, and then knight f3. So mapapansin natin lamang pa rin, pero this passed pawns on the c and b passed pawn proves fatal for black. So let's see, c7, c4, b6, queen c6, queen c6, and then rook b1. Eh, so mapapansin natin crucial na yung position, pero yung pass pawn ng white, since mas ma far advanced sila, is gives the player a stronger position. So after king h1, c3, knight d4, Antonio decides to give up the queen by playing b7. So ganun siya ka confident that his pawns will prove stronger than black's pieces after rook takes queen check, rook takes f1, rook f2, no? Tinatrap niya si Antonio kasi pag kinain niya may mate sa background by playing queen e1, rook g1, rook f8, b8 queen takes takes. So mapapansin natin rook knight versus rook. This is a one end game for white. And black resigned after the following moves: rook c1, rook b4, knight c6, rook c4, knight e5, g3, lalapit ng king, and it should be over. The following moves was just played for the sake of completeness, and then knight f2 mate. So thank you for listening, guys, and I hope you enjoy this game. See you next time.